There are near infinite ways to wire a battery bank. There's series wiring, there's parallel wiring, there's series parallel wiring. But what does all that mean? What does it look like? And what does it do for the overall battery bank voltage? Well, that's exactly what we're gonna cover today in lesson number 3 of this Battery Basics playlist. My name is Nate, and welcome to the Explorist Life Mobile, Marine, and Off-Grid Electrical Academy. Let's get started. We're just going to jump right into this with the most common battery bank wiring, and that's parallel battery wiring, which means positive battery terminals are connected to positive battery terminals and negative battery terminals are connected to negative battery terminals. And when you wire a battery bank in parallel, the battery bank voltage doesn't change based on how or what voltage of batteries you're using. For example, if you have two batteries wired in parallel, the positives are connected together and the negatives are connected together, and then you have a positive and a negative going to your loads and chargers. If this is a 12 volt battery bank, or a 12 volt battery, and this is a 12 volt battery, this whole battery bank is going to be a 12 volt battery bank because batteries wired in parallel, their voltages remain at the same voltage as the individual batteries. What if you have three batteries? It's the exact same thing. 1, 2, and 3, all 12 volt batteries, all the positives are connected together, all the negatives are connected together, and this results in a 12 volt battery bank. It's the exact same concept as the two battery version. What about four batteries? Same thing. Positives together, negatives together, 12 volt batteries, 12 volt battery bank. So, what if we have 24 volt batteries? Exact same concept, 24 volt batteries to a 24 volt battery bank, positives together, negatives together. Just ripping through it because you can start to see that all this starts to be the exact same, regardless of how many batteries that you're throwing at this system. 48 volt batteries, it's the exact same concept. So we can just keep doing that all day long. Now, are there other ways to wire batteries in parallel? And yes, there are. There's three more ways, but the other one that we're going to cover today is the other most popular way, and that's going to be the busbar method. And that's going to be wiring the positives from each battery to a busbar and the negatives from each battery to a different busbar. And for this, we would use something like the Victron Lynx Power In or the Lynx distributor, and it's got a positive bar here at the top, copper bar. This one's coated in tin to keep it corrosion resistant. And then a negative bus bar. Let's get these out of the way so it's easier to see. And then a negative bus bar down here. And you can see that in the diagram, the positives from the positive battery terminals are going to the positive bus bar, then feeding the rest of the system. And the negatives are going from each negative battery terminal to the negative bus bar and then feeding the system. So positives are connected to positives and negatives are connected to negatives. That connection is just happening up here instead of at the actual battery. Now you can do this with, you know, it doesn't really matter what voltage the batteries are. The concept remains the same. Batteries wired in parallel, their voltage is going to, the overall battery bank voltage is going to remain the same as the individual batteries. So in this diagram here, it's actually using this battery here, which is a 48 volt battery. So we have four 48 volt batteries. All the positives are connected together at the positive bus bar. Negatives are connected together at the negative bus bar. And this is a 48 volt battery bank system. So that's how the battery bank wiring works with parallel. But what about series battery wiring? So when you have a series wired battery bank, your positives are connected to your negatives for adjacent batteries. For this particular example, we got a 12 volt battery here, a 12 volt battery here. The positive is connected to the negative on neighboring batteries. And then you're pulling power from the opposite battery terminals here to go to the loads and chargers. Now, when you wire like this, it turns this battery bank of 12 volt batteries into a 24 volt battery bank. You're just adding the voltages of the batteries that are connected together. So if you have three batteries wired together, a 12 volt battery, a 12 volt battery, and a 12 volt battery, that's going to get you a 36 volt battery bank, positives connected to negatives for neighboring batteries. and then we're pulling power off of the far ends to go to our loads and chargers. Same thing with four batteries, 12 volt, 12 volt, 12 volt, 12 volt. That's going to result in a 48 volt battery bank. Positives are connected to negatives on neighboring batteries, with the positive and negative coming off of the entire battery bank to the loads and chargers. So what if we have 24 volt batteries? It's the exact same concept. 24 volt battery, 24 volt battery, positive connected to negative. We're just going to add these two together. That's going to give us a 48 volt battery bank. Those are connected to the rest of the system. So can you do both series and parallel? Yes, you absolutely can. So in some of our larger systems, we've done series parallel systems, which is going to be a positive and a negative connected to neighboring batteries, positive and a negative connected to neighboring batteries. So these two batteries are wired in series, these two batteries are wired in series, and then the positives are connected to positives and negatives are connected to negatives of each of the series strings of batteries, which are then going on to feed the rest of the system. So these two batteries wired in series, and then these two series strings are wired in parallel to the rest of the system. So we've got two 12 volt batteries in series, two series strings of batteries in parallel, which yields us a 24 volt battery bank, given we're using 12 volt batteries here. Now you can really do this with any amount of batteries that you sort of want to. It's the exact same concept in this one. This is 12 volt battery, 12 volt battery, 12 volt battery, 12 volt battery, positive to negative, positive to negative, positive to negative, giving us a 48 volt battery series string right here. And each one of these is wired in the exact same method. And then each of those series strings of batteries, the positive and negative is coming to the bus bar up here, where the positives are connected to positives and negatives are connected to negatives, which gives us an overall 48 volt battery bank using, I mean, this is 4, 8, 12, 16, 20, 24 batteries. So pros and cons of parallel series and series parallel. So a big con of series wiring of batteries is, you know, sort of for the beginner, it's sort of confusing, because if you wire the batteries like this with the positives and negatives connected together in this fashion, that's good. That's pretty perfect. But if you wire the wrong positives and the wrong negatives together, that's a direct short, and that's going to, best case scenario, trip a breaker, and you're going to have to reset the breaker or replace the fuse. Worst case scenario, it's going to rapidly combust. Cons of series and series parallel. Obviously, this is a lot of wiring. You know, this particular system, I stumbled into this system after parts were purchased. And there were already 24 batteries purchased, and we just sort of had to make do with it. And so I would never actually recommend doing this, just because of the sheer volume of wiring that had to be done to wire this battery together. In addition to that, each of these batteries, when you're wiring batteries in series, every battery has to be pre-charged to 100% before it gets wired into the overall battery bank. So in this particular system, it was a totally off-grid house, and they had to pre-charge each of these batteries to 100%, which means they had to have their generator running for like 3 days to basically recharge all of these batteries, reset, reconnect. It was just a huge pain. And so that's just a pain point of series wired batteries in general. So what are the cons to parallel wiring? Basically nothing. There's realistically not a whole lot of cons to parallel wiring. It's sort of the most straightforward method. You know, as long as you can wrap your head around, you're always connecting positives together, you're always connecting negatives together. And if you have a positive to negative connection at somewhere in this system, you've done something wrong, then that's sort of a nice little like easy check to self-check your own work before, you know, something goes wrong. So if you're using 12 volt batteries, this is a 12 volt system. If you're using 24 volt batteries, this is a 24 volt system. 48 volt batteries, 48 volt system. Now the con of wiring in diagonal like this versus in a bus bar method like this, there's pros and cons to each of these. These two are basically the same. They're just using different styles of batteries. This particular one is using a Victron Smart NG battery here, but the exact same battery bank wiring method could be used for any of these batteries on the table. This furthest one right here, this is using these batteries here. It's a Rich Solar rack style battery, and that's that. Now, this system where you're wiring these batteries in diagonal like this, where the batteries are going positive to positive to positive to positive to positive to positive, and then feeding the system, a lot of battery manufacturers put a limit on the number of batteries that you can wire in this fashion. Sometimes it's 4, sometimes it's 6. Some battery manufacturers don't want you to do this at all, and they would instead rather you do busbar wiring like this. Now, the con of this is going to be it's just more wiring. You know, if this is 5 feet from here to there, you know you're going to be 5 feet of wire and 5 feet of wire. You know, that system over there, that's 20 feet of wire basically for 4 batteries. And so there's just more wiring and a little more space involved in the busbar parallel wiring method. But it's still a great system, you know, depending on your needs. If you're doing a smaller system, you know, 2 to 3 kVA inverter charger with, you know, 4 or fewer batteries, I'm always going to go with this method here, unless the battery manufacturer recommends against it. Otherwise, we're going with this. So how many batteries can you add to a parallel wired busbar method battery bank? It's realistically, it's near infinite, because we can take these busbars here and we can link them together, and you could put, you know, 30, 40, 50 batteries if you wanted to. We'll run into some other limitations that are more technical that don't have to do with the actual wiring, but you know, you can put a ton of batteries. Now, for this particular system, if we were using 100 amp hour batteries, you know, for, I would probably just start recommending some larger batteries. You know, that's a 100 amp hour battery there. Battleborn also makes a 270 amp hour battery that we could put a couple of those in parallel like this. This one over here is an Epoch 460 amp hour battery. And so you can put fewer batteries into the same battery bank and still meet your battery capacity needs. And so there's a couple pros and cons there, but you know, realistically, if you need some additional help or support and trying to like figure out which one is going to be best for your system, you know, hit us up at shop.explorist.life. A little messenger bot down in the bottom right-hand corner will hook you up to our support team, and we can get you pointed in the right direction, or support@explorist.life. But that is the general overview of how you wire series versus parallel batteries and what it does to the battery bank voltage. Now, what we didn't cover is why you would need a different battery bank voltage, and that's going to be coming up in an upcoming video. So consider subscribing if you haven't done so already. I hope this was insightful. We'll see you in the next video.